Hey guys, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how Laravel, Inertia, and React works together in the same application. We'll be creating new pages and setting up routes for these pages. We will also be looking at how you can send variables from your Laravel backend and receive them as props in your React frontend. In the previous episode, we installed Laravel with Inertia, React, and TypeScript. If you're not sure how to do that, I'll leave a link in the description to that video so you can check it out as well. Now, if we look at our routes file, you can see that we've got a simple get route to the root location. And if you use Laravel with the Blade engine, you would simply return a view method, and the first parameter would be the name of the view you want to display. Now, with Inertia, this is very similar. So instead of returning the view, we would return the Inertia class, calling the static render method, and then pass in the name of our view we want to display. Okay, so we can remove this line, save it, and refresh, and we still have our welcome page. Okay, so by default, your views or your pages needs to live in the resources JS pages folder. As you can see, this welcome view is the welcome page we see currently on the screen. And because this is the default location, we don't need to call the whole path when we call the view inside our inertia render method. We can, however, change this default location if you go into your app.tsx file, which is the default entry point for your React application, by changing the require statement inside the create inertia app. Okay, so as an example, let's change this pages to views, and then our pages folder, we rename that to views as well. Let's refresh our browser to see if our welcome page still shows up. And so it does. That's how you can change the default location of your pages or views folder. Okay, so let's create a new page. Now inside our pages folder, let's create a folder called users. And then inside our users, we're gonna create a new view or a new page called index. This is where we're gonna display all the users in our system. And we call it index because we want to follow the CRUD naming conventions. Okay, so let's go ahead and create our React component. And we call it constant index because that's what our component name is going to be. It's going to be an arrow function that returns a fragment that displays users index page. And because we're using TypeScript, we should also type hint our component as being a React functional component. And depending on the React version you use, you might need to import React at the top. Now, the last thing we need to do is to export the component. And because this is a page, you need to export it as the default export for this file. Now, you might have noticed by default, the tab spaces in the React side of the application is 4 instead of 2. Now, you can change that in your editor config file by adding the extensions and then saying your indent size should be 2. Okay, so now if we save this file, go back to our index, you can see the tab spaces is now 2 instead of 4. So let's just fix up our code. Okay, so let's create a route for our new page. And we create a simple get route to the user's path and return the inertia render method with the users slash index view. Now we call it the users index because this is the folder that we're calling and this is the file inside the users folder. We don't need to call the pages folder because that is our default. We only need to specify the users folder and then the index file inside the users folder. Okay, so let's go ahead and call that route. So we just go to /users and it should show our users index page, which it does, users index page, meaning that our routing and our page is working correctly. Okay, so before we move on to the last section, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, if you haven't subscribed yet, please consider doing it now. And also remember to turn on notifications so you don't miss out when I upload more content like this. Okay, so now in the last section, I'm going to show you how you can send variables from your Laravel backend and receive them as React props in your frontend. Now, similar to sending variables in a blade view to the frontend, you would also use the second parameter in your inertia render method to send your variables to the frontend. Okay, so as an example, we're going to send the name variable as Dan, and then the company as coding with pixel fix to the front end. Okay, so now if we go back to our user index page, in our component, we need to receive the props as the properties that's being sent from the backend. And let's go ahead and print out our properties like this. We can access it via props.name and props.company, because that is what we called it when we sent it from the Laravel backend. Okay, now as you can see, the name and the company has got red squiggly lines underneath it. This is because of TypeScript, which we will fix up in a sec. Okay, so if we go to our web and refresh, we should see the name and company being printed out now. And there we go, name Dan and company coding with PixelFix. Okay, so let's go ahead and quickly fix up our TypeScript issue. What we do is we create a simple interface called iIndexProps, and then we say that we expect it to have a name property of type string and a company property of type string as well. Then in our definition, we specify that our functional component should be of type iIndexProps. And now as you can see, the red squiggly lines disappeared, meaning the TypeScript is happy. And now if we go over to our web and refresh, everything should still be working the same. And there we go. All the information is still being printed out. And that's it for this episode, guys. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.